In the mid-1930s, swing became a big part of jazz. Swing is the basic rhythm of jazz. Swinging means being in sync with other people and loving it. Swing as a jazz style first appeared during the Great Depression. The optimistic feeling of swing lifted the spirits of everyone in America. By the mid-1930s, a period known as the swing era, swing dancing had become our national dance, and big hands were playing this style of music. Orchestra leaders such as Duke Ellington, Count Basie, Fletcher Henderson, Paul Whiteman, and Benny Goodman led some of the greatest bands of the era. Another really significant figure in music history, Edward Kennedy, Duke Ellington. We know him as Duke Ellington. Was born on April 29, 1899 in Washington, D.C. He began studying the piano at the age of 7. He started playing jazz as a teenager and moved to New York City to become a band leader. As a pianist, composer, and band leader, Ellington was one of the creators of the big band sound, which fueled the swing era. Big band is a large ensemble in jazz, which is composed of, but not limited to, clarinets, alto, tenor, barry saxophone, sometimes soprano saxophone, a trumpet line, a trombone line, a set drum, and pianist, and stand-up bass. He continued leading and composing for his jazz orchestra until his death in 1974. Billy Strayhorn, a composer and arranger, said that Ellington plays the piano, but his real instrument is his band. Each member of his band is to him a distinctive tone color and set of emotions or feelings, which he mixes with others equally distinctive and to produce a third thing, which I like to call the Ellington effect. Duke Ellington was a famous composer, and his music is still played today. I'll leave one piece of music for you, which I'll put the title of on the screen. And I really hope you enjoy this, because Duke Ellington is something else.